So I have some cool stuff to share with you guys today. These are two new bags from Peter McKinnon and Nomadic. This is the everyday camera bag, and this is the smaller sling bag. And I want to go through these with you guys today. There's some very cool stuff on them. I've been shooting with these for probably the last two-ish weeks or so. And I'm really liking what I'm seeing. So if you guys remember, the first bag that Peter and Nomadic did was this one. And this was a really big bag. I actually have two of these. I actually use them both. It's an awesome bag. It's designed with a very different intent than the new stuff. This bag was designed to carry pretty much everything you would need on a short trip. So like maybe 4 days, you could put some clothes in here, you could put a lot of camera gear, you can stuff the whole thing with camera gear. Like I said, I've got two of these, I actually use them all the time. It's a great bag. These have a very different design philosophy. So we'll start with the everyday camera bag. Now this bag is actually designed just for daily use. So let's say you've got a photo walk you're going on, you're gonna go on a photo shoot, you're coming to work, going to the coffee shop, everything that you're gonna need to get you through the day should fit in this bag just fine. There's two things that I love about this bag. Even though it is a little bit smaller than the first bag, it still holds a lot of stuff. It's very efficiently designed. The second thing I love, it is highly customizable. The first design feature you're gonna notice is we have two pockets, one on each side, and these are held shut with magnets. So if you're not using them, they stay close to the bag and they're not flapping around. But if you do want to use them, I can put a water bottle, let's say, in one side, and I can also add maybe a tripod to the other. I'm gonna need both these today, so I am good to go, ready to go. When I'm not using them, I just simply shut it. We'll use the magnets to hold it close, and we are set either way. So there's two ways that we can access the interior of this bag. You can access it through the top or the back. We're gonna start with the top. This has a little shelf here that Nomadic call the loft. This is a very cool feature. It's actually big enough. Let's say I wanna put a Canon R5 with the 24-105mm f/4 lens. Fits easily. In fact, I've got room for more. So you could put your camera up here. That's a really good way if you want quick, easy access. Or you can keep your cameras in the back and you can put something else up here, like there is an optional accessory that is a tech bag that fits really nicely up here. So if you want to put your GoPro stuff, or you want to put cables, batteries, things that you need to access like that, that could go up here too. Now, this is actually customizable, but I have to show you the back first. Much like the original bag, we also have access from the back. So this zipper will get you into the back. Now, the way this works is we have a series of compartments in here. This is actually very cool. So these are camera cubes is what they call these. There's different configurations that you can get. You can get one that's just one big camera cube. I have the dual camera cubes, so this is cool because I can actually remove this. I have this one set up for my drone right now, and then the other one, I've got Sony A7 R4 with the 35mm G Master. I've got some smaller accessories, body caps, lens caps, headphones, so on and so forth, anything that I'm going to need throughout the day. What's cool about this is you could actually get additional, like these half-size camera cubes or even the full size, and you can have these set up and kind of ready to go. So if I know I'm gonna need the drone that day, then I just grab the cube, stick it in the bag. If I know I need maybe a Canon setup, I can put that and stick it in the bag. So you can kind of custom configure that. The other thing is each one of these cubes also has Velcro dividers inside, so that's a really nice way to customize it further. And of course, you can get it just with a configuration of these Velcro dividers if you just want to use this whole space. Now, I want to show you something else additionally cool about this is I can actually customize this whole space. So you can see that we have the loft up here. We actually have a door here that gives us rear entry to the loft. So I can get in from the backside if I don't want to bother with opening the top. Just need to get in there real quick from the back, you can do so. And this has magnets that hold that in place too. But I can actually configure the loft. So what's cool is I can take this centerpiece, push this outward, and this is going to reduce the space in the back, but it's going to double the space in the loft. So that's the first configuration. So I could put one of these camera cubes in there. I'm still ready to go. Or there is a third configuration where I can actually bring this all the way down, and you can stick this in sideways. So if you just want a deep case that goes down to one of these camera cubes, you can set it up that way too. That might be really cool if you're taking a short flight or something and need to put clothes in the top. You can put your cameras in the bottom. I'm going to go back to my default configuration here. One thing I want to note here is that this version of this bag actually is a prototype version, so I know the production version will have some minor changes for the better. One I want to point out is in the loft section here, especially on the sides, they are going to add some additional pockets for smaller items. So if you want to be able to just put some smaller stuff up in that loft section, you can. But I love the way this is configurable. I have basically, they kind of call this the ladder, but there's three different versions depending on how I fold that out that I can actually get out of this bag. That's one of the things I love. It makes it really customizable and it's just super comfortable too. Did a really nice job on here. Go ahead and zip it up. And when you are all packed up and ready to go on with your day. Just pop it over your shoulder and you're good to go. Now, let's check out the sling bag. Okay, so this is the sling bag. So this is an awesome bag. This is a completely different bag, completely different idea and approach to design. So this bag is for, let's say you just want to go out, you're going to get a couple shots, you want to bring one body, maybe a small lens, and you got your keys and a couple other odds and ends. Well, you don't want to bring a big bag for something like that. So the sling bag is absolutely perfect. So on the exterior, we've got the sling strap, we've got a third strap for stability here. And the way I love how this is organized, when I open this up, you're gonna see that it's kind of a clamshell configuration, and I can open it up and literally see everything that's in this bag. Nothing gets lost or hidden. You know how keys, you're looking for them because they got under something. I love how open this is, and you can access everything directly. So I've even got my Hasselblad X1D in here right now, so medium format, let's go get some shots. Now, the other cool thing that I love about this bag, if you've ever used sling bags before, one of the problems that you're gonna run into is this. You unzip the bag, you open it up, you grab your camera, you have other things in here. You don't want them to fall out, so you've got to grab the zipper over here with this hand, and you're kind of, well, you're doing that number. That's no fun. So there is a hack to get around this. So I absolutely love this. So when you open this up, one thing you're going to see under the lip of the bag here is this piece of elastic. And so there's also a button at the top of the bag. So what you're gonna do here is I can take my camera out and then all one-handed, I grab the elastic, I bring it up, attach it to the button so I can shoot, take all my images, it's closed enough, nothing's gonna leave. Then when I'm ready to go back, I can put the camera away and then I can totally zip up the bag. I love this hack. This is one of my favorite things about this bag. It really just, it makes it come together and it separates it from being just another sling bag. So very cool there. So we've got the everyday camera bag, the sling bag. I've been using these for a couple weeks now. A couple observations that I do want to note on here. So first of all, I love that these bags are really rugged. They're really nice bags, and this is the case with the original bag that Peter McKinnon did with Nomadic. I've been using that bag a lot. As I said, I got two of those. I love that it's very rugged. I thought that at first that bag was gonna get scratched up and start getting dinged up really quickly, and it, believe it or not, it isn't. It looks as good as new. It's a really tough bag, and so I do like that. The other thing that I want to note on these is that depending on what your needs are and what you want to configure, this everyday carry bag is just that. It is an everyday carry bag. So if you, it's very mirrorless friendly, and you can kind of get bigger cameras in here, especially if you need to leave lenses attached and whatnot, you can get the bigger camera cube or just use the dividers and you can set it up that way. It still will close very snug, even though it is a little bit more, it's a little less deep than the original bag. It still has enough flexibility. So if your camera's sticking up over the top, you can still get it in there just fine. It's not gonna break anything. It's actually really good. But if you do carry a lot of equipment and you carry a lot of lenses, I still think the original bag has a place for that. I personally needed a bag like this, so I'm really excited to see both these. And actually, the sling bag isn't something that I thought I would need necessarily, but I've ended up really enjoying this a lot. This is just a super quick, it may be more of an everyday carry than the actual everyday camera bag, even though they're both designed for that purpose. I use this one a lot. I think it's really cool. So you should go check these out. How do you get them, you might be asking? Well, there is a Kickstarter campaign set up right now. I will link that below this video. So you should go check it out and support these guys. Peter's obviously a great YouTuber, a fantastic photographer, and I think these bags, they've just done an incredible job designing. I think they're very useful and highly recommended. So anyway, check it out. If you guys got any questions, drop them in the comments below. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, later.